understand. Nice to see you there. Today, I'm going to give you a perfect guide on how to carry out the titration between sodium hydrogen tetrahydrosulfate and sodium hydroxide. Remember, in my previous video, I gave teachers guide on how to prepare the standard solutions. Here is the sodium hydrogen tetrahydrosulfate solution, which is actually a solution of an acid salt. And here is the standard solution of sodium hydroxide. So you endeavor to watch the video to know how I prepare this for teachers. Then for you as students, in this video, I'll give you the guide on how to do your titration, the accurate endpoints, the range of the endpoints, and the likely questions that you follow. Then in your titration, remember you need your burette, which is here very standard. We have a 15 mL standard burette. We use that over here in Nigeria. There are other volumes, 100, 150, but for examinations here in Nigeria, we use a 15 mL burette. Then you need your funnel. Then you need your white tie to notice the color change, of course. Then in this type of titration, we also need an indicator, just a normal acid-based titration. The indicator that can serve here, you can use phenolphthalein, you can use methyl orange. Here, I'm going to use methyl orange. Just know that the color changes are not going to be the same. When I use methyl orange, the color in base is going to be yellow, and endpoints will give me either orange or very pale pink. But when I use phenolphthalein, the color in base is going to be very pink, pinkish or red, so that the endpoint color change will be colorless. Remember, phenolphthalein is colorless in acid, and it is pink in base. So normally, I'm going to use two pipettes. Here we have pipettes. Here is what we call the bulb pipettes or the volumetric pipettes used for titration mainly by students. And here is my graduated pipette. I will use both of them to see the actual endpoint. Then this is of two standard volumes, 20 and 25 cm3. So one scoop, use only one. And remember to listen to your chemistry teacher and know the volume, or look at your own while titrating. If it is 25, you record it well. Then endeavor to make your table. You see how to make the table there on the screen. Then on top of your table, don't forget to write the volume of paper to use and also the indicator used in this type of titration. Remember, this titration is actually targeted towards producing a normal salt from an acid salt by complete neutralization. Over here is an acid salt which has still unreplaceable hydrogen ions. The hydrogen ions in the acid that formed it is partially replaced. Then I'm going to use this base to replace it completely so that there will be a normal salt from this acid salt. So first, here we go, we don't need to waste much time, but endeavor to read the questions, and I'm not going to be providing the answers here in this video. You stay subscribed and check my community posts to know when I'll go live. You might require to pay. If it is not for free, you endeavor to pay to join in that live stream. Well, read the questions and also answer your own questions whenever you're having a problem. So here we move. I bring down my acid here. And remember to wash everything. I've actually done the washing. And over here, I'm using a pipette. A student find it difficult to prepare with this. They usually have the risk of drinking the base. So I advise this method. I created it. I started a ball, a pipette ball. Inside it, just like using the red, then I converted the same thing. Some used tap, like this one I'm using is using tap, some use this ball. So this ball makes the sucking easier. So when you pursue the ball, you can easily suck the liquid gradually without applying much force. So let's go. Okay. I'll gradually press the ball and go down to the mark. Yeah, that's it. So I've gotten my 25 mL. So what I do, I think this is pretty easier. So if you want that method, remember I supply all this. Just go and get get it to you anywhere you are. Okay. So this is now indicating yellow. Your first titration is actually called rough, and in rough titration, you're advised not to look at this directly. Look down into the conical flask. This is what we call Erlenmeyer flask or conical flask. Don't bother, the student will be forced to looking at the directs. No, you never know where you are going to. For the first titration, is just called rough, and the advantages of rough titration is that it helps to adapt the apparatus to the reagents. Like, I've not used this reagents on these apparatus today. So the first titration I'm running is a kind of washing it off with the chemical. And the, another importance of rough is that it predicts the range of the endpoint. So the most difficult titration for experts like us is the rough titration. If I get my rough titration, another subsequent titration will be easy because the rough will predict the range where the endpoint actually lies. And remember that endpoint is the point where neutralization is complete, as shown by the color change of the indicator used. So let's go. You keep your eye inside the mouth for us. Gently swirl. Almost there. A drop will not give us what we want. Okay, that's it. So this orange, and that shows complete neutralization. And in my burette here, I have 22.5. That should be the burette reading and the approximate. I will run the titration again. So 22.5 is actually the range of the endpoint. It shows that even if this titration is not accurate, it shows that my endpoint lies between 20 and 25. So, and that should also be your own range. If you use 25 mil of bulb pipette, your endpoint should be from 20 to 25 also. It is within a range. It's not going to be accurate, but getting something above 25, I think, is not normal. Because the acid salt, when you write the equation and see that the endpoint range will be within that, then endeavor that your student will also do the same titration if you're a teacher. Then if you're a student, you'll be provided with the accurate amount of reagents that you require to run your titration up to 4 times, and you make your table as you can see there on the screen. So for me to run another one, I would like to use the graduated pipette. After each titration, you rinse the Erlenmeyer flask with distilled water or tap water. See, I made a mark here with a tape that shows for acids, for base. So with my pipette ball, okay, this is my base actually. So the volume of this pipette is actually 20 ml. Here I titrated 25. Here I'm now using 20 ml. The graduated pipette says 20 ml. That's the capacity. So let me get my acid. What is it? How are you? Good. Closer to camera so that you can see well. This is exactly 18.5.
Okay. Okay, the reading shows 18.5 against 20 cm cube portions of B.
Let me repeat the title of this one. Precautions that you have to take. Remember, you don't titrate while the funnel is still inside the burette. So to avoid wasting time here, I'm taking my initial to be 10. In the second titration, my initial is 10. So you record in your table. The first titration I did my initial 0.00, but here I'm making the initial 10.00. Then you might be told to add water to this after measuring. Remember, if you add water to this, it will have no effect on the endpoint because water is neutral. After measuring and you add water to the base before titration, the endpoint will be unaffected because water molecules are neutral. They are not being neutralized. What is being neutralized is that the base molecules. But when you add water to the stock solution before measuring out, the endpoint might be affected. So you add your indicator. Two or three drops of indicator is enough. Depending on the concentration of the indicator, you can also, if you need guide on how to make the indicator solutions for phenolphthalein, methyl rings, conjure edge, remember to request for one. Okay, this is indicating base. So what I do, remember my first sample was 22, so I would rather get to 20 before shaking, because my initial here is 10. Or even to 25, you might be looking as if it's neutral, but it isn't. When you shake it, you see it becomes yellow again. Then you now gradually trace your endpoint. Okay, and then this little excess acid compared to the other previous one, little excess acid. So over here, my final is 34. So here is 34. Okay, so how do you get your average volume of air used? My initial was 10, final is 34. So you just do 34 minus 10, which will give you 24. But actually, I added excess acid just to demonstrate for you to know when you have exceeded the endpoint. So it's unfortunate I've fallen away there that I'm supposed to compare. So here, it is actually taking it as 23. So the endpoint here is 23, and I advise you work with that. Then listen to your school chemistry teacher because it's the one that will determine the one your school will use and follow strictly the rules. Then you can see the questions, the four possible questions that follow is there on the screen. And then don't forget to subscribe and share my videos. I wish you the best of luck. Her Majesty the World Science Channel is good for you. Don't be an object object. Spread the light. Bye for now.
Our Alpha and Omega.